Hello everyone, in today's video, I'll be showing you how you can disable sound, disable fog, and disable shadows all inside of your Roblox Studio game. You can also re-enable these at any point you'd like. Let's start off by pressing our starter GUI and inserting a screen GUI. We can rename this to settings. Once you have your screen GUI renamed to settings, we can insert a frame. And at this point, we just want to make a nice frame where our settings are going to be. I'll fast forward this and see you when I'm done making this frame. This is how your settings frame should look like when you're done making it, or if it's already done. You have to include an X button right here and a cog, or a little image that you can press to open it. You don't have to have an image, you can just type in settings, but I used a cog. You can just go into toolbox. You can just simply go into your toolbox, go into images and search for cog. I use this cog if you want to use the same cog that I did. And then this is optional right here. Your settings menu thing is optional, but I think it's helpful. Okay. Now let's actually get into adding our settings. So what we want to do is we want to click on the frame and insert a button and put in three buttons, one being your fog, another being the sound, and one last one, which is the shadows. I'm going to do that really quickly right now. Okay, once you've added in your three settings, your settings menu should look like this. And to make this a little bit easier to navigate, let's rename this to fog setting, and then get to the next one, which this one is shadow, so shadow setting, and one last one, which should be your sound setting. There we go, this will make it easier to navigate. You don't have to name them, but I did just because now I sort of know which one is which without having to click on each one trying to figure it out. Okay, let's start off with probably one of the easiest ones to disable, which is shadows. Insert a local script and we have to check if our shadow setting has been pressed. Actually, let's rename this to set setting. Whoops, set setting. There we go. So this is going to be our set the setting script. Okay. So what we want to do is script.parent. Mousebell one click colon connect function and press enter after you've done one of these little things. It should automatically complete. Now we can go if script.parent.text is equal to disable shadow. Yep. Shadow, then you have to make sure it's equal. Then what we can do is simply copy this, paste this in, and we'll set the text to enable shadow. Then after it's set to be enabling the shadow, we have to actually disable the shadow. So we can go game dot lighting dot global shadows dot no is equal to false no yeah is equal to false okay so when we press this, it'll equal to false, or yeah, it'll turn off our shadows. Now after we press this, you can go test this out. I'll test this out just to show you. So if we go disable shadows, I know what I did wrong. I accidentally forgot to remove that equals there. Okay, just remove that equal sign. Now if we test out and we press disable shadows, nope, still doesn't work. Let's see. Disable shadows. We have to set it to disable shadows, sorry. Okay, make sure that you call it exactly what I did. Okay, so as you can see, we disabled the shadows, but we can't re-enable them. We could copy and paste this and do something like that, and just change this to enable. But the issue with this is that once this runs, then it'll run this, and because we set the shadows to be enabled, it will just reset them, so nothing will happen. So what we have to do is we have to go ahead and do an else if. And then we can just copy everything but that if and paste that in. There we go. Else if enable shadows, then we can equal to disable shadows. And then set this to be true. Now if we test this out, as you can see, we can go disable and enable. So we can click this as fast as we want. And now we're pretty much done. There's really not much we have to do next besides duplicating this and just creating some different settings. So inside of the fog, we can actually sort of leave it this way. But when we want to disable our shadows, we can, instead we're going to go game.lighting.fogend and game.lighting.fogstart. Doesn't really matter which order here, but we can just do game is equal to lighting.fogend is equal to math.huge. What math.huge is, if I actually do this, and we can just do print math.huge. As you can see, math.huge is just... What happened here? Oh, it didn't print this out. Okay, how's a better way to show this? Okay, let's just go copy this. Equal to math.huge. There we go. So now, if we do this, it should... So yeah, it's pretty much just infinite. It's a huge number. It's pretty much just infinite, as you can see right here. It's really big. There is a number, but it's too big for Roblox Studio. Also, Roblox just set to an infinite number, which is a really big number. So what we can now do is it'll just pretty much set this to be infinite. We can copy and paste this and just set this back to what our fog was originally at. So if our fog was at 175, we're going to set our fog end to be at 100 and our fog start to be at 75. Now, if we press this, we can go disable our fog. What happened? Oh, we have to go make sure to rename this to disable fog. And rename this, and rename that. There we go. Now, what we can do is disable shadows and disable our fog. So there we go. We have two of our settings done. We just have to disable our sounds. Sounds, depending on how many sounds you have, it could be a little bit more... It's not complicated, it just will take a little longer, because you have to find every sound in your game, pretty much. And there are other ways to do this, but the way I'm going to do it is probably going to be the simplest, and will probably work the best if you have sounds in, like, different parts. So, it could be a little issue if you have a bunch of sounds, and there's not really any way to fully disable it in, like, the sound service, not that I believe. Unless there's, like, a way, but I haven't actually... I tried experimenting with everything. I don't know if this does something, but... I doubt it. Anyways. Just duplicate that. Whoops. Duplicate. Yeah, it's already duplicated. Okay. So, what we want to do is disable this to disable sound. Control C. Paste that in. Okay, so math.huge. What we can do is just delete this. And I have a folder for my sounds, right? And I just named the sound to sounds. So, I like to have a folder with all the sounds just because it's really easy to find all the sounds. That's what I usually like to do. You might like to do something else, but just having a folder with all your sounds is probably the easiest. Okay, now we can do is game.workspace.sounds.sound.volume is equal to 0. And then we can copy and paste this. And paste that in right there, and set it to 0.5 because that's the default. Okay, and that's pretty much it. So if you have one sound in your game, it's going to be really fast, but if you have multiple, you might have to do this like a bunch of times and then redo everything for the same thing. But I only have one, so I only have to do it once. So this can be the easiest one and can be the hardest one. Okay, now if we hit play, we should be done. We can disable our shadows, disable our fog, and disable our sound. As you can see, now we just have to close and open it. And closing and open should be fairly simple. I'm going to rename this text button to close. And then inside of here, we're going to add in a local script. And script.parent.mouseButtonClick:connect function, blah, blah, blah. And then we just have to do script.parent.parent.visible equals false. And then we can copy this script and add another one in this one right here. And we can just turn this to true, but we have to go script.parent.parent.frame. There we go. And now we can simply disable this frame, set to visible. We can close out of these scripts and press play. And now, as you can see, this should be all done. We can disable our shadows, disable our fog, and disable the sounds. And just like that, you have made a shadows menu. Very simple. Anyways, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I'm trying to make all my videos better than the previous one. And thanks for everyone for subscribing. And we hit 30 subscribers. Let's see if we can get 50 subscribers soon. Anyways, thanks for watching. See you guys.